Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Welcome to this new video on Operation Patriot. Today we are doing mission number 2. And here I've already laid down the deck to create that random mission. So let's dive straight into mission selection. So the first thing is the objective, eliminate an enemy patrol. A Russian unit has been seen killing National Guard soldiers that try to surrender. Killing that unit will send a clear message to other enemy units. Setup: for this mission, only use one level 2 enemy card from the enemy force deck. This enemy level 2 is the patrol that needs to be killed. So basically, yeah, I just need to identify which will be the enemy level 2, and I need to kill all this team for the mission to be a success. For the location, we will be on the shipping port. Okay, that's cool, that changed a bit. So we'll have some boats laying around. For the enemy presence, medium, so 3 level 1, 1 level 2, 1 level 3, so quite a lot of enemy to deal with. For the civilian presence, it will be heavy, okay, so heavy civilian presence in that shipping port. And I have again access to off-table asset and observation point, though I don't have any off-table asset support now early on the campaign. That's a shame. Okay, so that's the setup for that mission. Again, that mission doesn't grant any reward. That's a bit of a shame, but yeah, let's focus on that and let's set up the board. Okay, so table has been set. We are in that shipping port area. So we have two boats over here. We have that warehouse. We have that industrial zone over here. Then we have a small street. We have a few buildings on that side. And that will be the board for today's mission. So I place all the small token here. One of these will be the level 2 enemy, the squad that we need to kill for the mission to be a success. I don't need to kill anyone else. If I can just manage to kill that squad, that will be perfect. Hoping it won't be like a tank or a BTR, because I'm not equipped with anti-armor weapon. So yeah, we'll see what we end up with that level 2 squad. So that's it for the board. Now let's have a look at the squad. So this is the squad I'm going to play with today. So here we have William Dunn, the team leader. We have Wolf Taylor, one of the assaulters. We have Kenneth X. Nolan, a second assaulter. We have Joseph Maylan, a sniper. Maya, which is our undercover operator. And we have Sasha Cooper, which is another assaulter. I've tweaked a bit the rules since the last time. I'm playing the supplement for the couple of force missions, so I'm still tweaking a bit the rules. So in the first place, I was thinking that we could bring 8 operators on a mission, but I think it's a bit too much. So now I will limit the number of soldiers on the ground to 6. In addition to that, they can have 2 additional supports. So the 2 additional supports can either be 2 ghosts on an observation point, like outside of the board, providing sniper fire, or those 2 supports can also be drones. So in that mission, I'm going to take 6 ghosts on the ground plus 1 drone support. And this will be that Puma UAV here. And here's the little card with it. Basically, I will select a random position for him to start. On each turn movement phase, I'm going to move him 30 inches. It can't be detected since it's flying high in the air. And every turn I can try to detect 1 hidden token. So basically, since I'm trying to detect as soon as possible that level 2 enemy card, I want as quickly as possible to uncover all of these. So yeah, that's why I'm using that recon drone for that mission. Also, I don't have any recon operator, so I don't have like the small quadcopter drone. So that's why also I'm bringing this drone for this mission. Okay, so I've placed my team on one of the extract slash infill points, so that's all the white dice that you can see on the edge. So here my almost the whole team will start here, and I just have my undercover operator that will start here. I will try to sneak inside the base, maybe stop just at the entrance. We'll see what we end up dealing with at the entry point here. So that's our initial placement. We have that drone here. I randomly place him here. He will move on the edge 30 inches and he will try to do some detection roll every turn. So now let's jump onto the first turn. First turn, end of my movement phase. So I started advancing with Maya here. My drone also move 30 inches on the board edge and the team advance toward here. I'm going to probably stack up my team over here, wait for my sniper to arrive on top of the building to provide overwatch. I will try to do a detection test with that drone on that enemy placement token. Here I detect on 4+, 4, 5, 6 and a 5, I detect what we have over here. So we'll take my and here we have a clear, so nothing on that enemy placement token. So now for now we are good here. Turn 2, we start first with a Fog of War card, so it's on a 6 for now, and a 4, so no Fog of War card this turn. I can jump right away onto the movement phase. So my sniper here will move 4 inches up the ladder, so 4 inches it's agility stat, I think it's 4 or maybe 5. So he basically arrive here this turn. The rest of the team here will move and will actually jump through that window here. So I'm just going to do an agility test to see if they can just enter through that. So for each of them they can only fail on a 6. So 1, 3, my leader and Sasha here. Oh, actually Sasha can't go inside that building for now, so Sasha will remain here. The rest of the team will move in. Here on that side, I'm just going to peek slightly with Maya just to have a line of sight on that placement token. Here I have line of sight now, or I should have line of sight. Okay, so I need to peek a bit more. Something like that. So now I have a line of sight on that placement token. We can discover what it is. So let's have a look at my deck here. And we have a level 1. We have our first level 1 enemy group. I've reworked a bit that table just because, I wanted a few custom things. So let's see what we end up with. So level 1. And it's a 9. A 9 will give us 3 trained riflemen and 1 trained sniper. So that's why I actually reworked that table. I wanted to have a bit more snipers in the game. So we'll have 3 riflemen here. The sniper spawn on the closest, highest possible and logical point. And in our case, it will be on top of this point over here. So that's the patrol guarding the entry. We have the sniper on top here. I'm just going to take that dice to randomly define the direction the sniper is facing, and he's facing roughly towards something like that. So now those guys, they were looking at that direction, so they may have saw Sasha. The thing is, Sasha is an undercover operator, so it's just basically a civilian, so they don't really care about her for now. So that's the end of the turn. We can jump onto the movement phase for the enemy. Actually, I just forgot also to move my drone. My drone have in line of sight that enemy placement token, so I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to unveil one card. Oh, and we have the enemy leader. We have the enemy leader straight out of that camp. Oh, what? 1919, what do we have here? We have 3 professional riflemen, 1 professional machine gun, 1 professional commander. So, 5-man Spetsnaz team that is sitting outside the base. So that's the small Spetsnaz team that just spawned inside our mission today. So now we can jump onto the enemy movement phase. And I'm going to actually right away with you move that team here. That team here is moving, is not moving actually, just looking at the opposite direction. And now doing the same thing for all the placement token. So there is just that token that move a bit more toward the front of the house, and we have Wolf inside the building that may see this model. So on a 4-5-6, he can see what we have here. And it's a 6, so he detects what we have here. And here we have a civilian. Okay, a civilian will be placed over here. So that's basically it for this turn. I've moved, the enemy have moved, we jump on to turn 3. Turn 3, we start with the Fog of War card. Fog of War card is now on a 5. I'm placing those tech now here just to avoid like going in all directions with the camera. Oh, okay, so 6, we have a first Fog of War card. Okay, car alarm. A car alarm has just gone off, attracting nearby enemies. Randomly select the car. 1d6 enemy placement token will run toward it. If the alert was not raised before the alarm gone off, every enemy that are not moving toward the car will enter Overwatch. The alert is removed when the enemy enters a 2-inch radius from that car. Okay, so let's roll first to select the vehicle. So on 1-2-3, it will be a vehicle from the compound, and on 4-5-6, a vehicle from the street. And on 4-5-6, it's a vehicle from the street. So so basically, yeah, one. Oh, we have, how many vehicles do we have? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have 6 and 7. Ah. So let's say let's say on a 1, 2, 3 it will be one of those three here, and on a 4, 5, 6 it will be one of the four there. So 1, 2, 3 it will be one of those, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3-4, so enemy are attracted by that Range Rover here. So 1d6 enemy run towards, that's right. 1d6 enemy placement token run towards it. And everyone else enter Overwatch basically. So how many enemy? We have 4 enemy placement token that move towards the car. Well, it will be actually 3 placement tokens plus the nearby enemies. So we have this group here that will move 6 inches. So basically, they move, they do they just move their agility, moving on top of this. We have this placement token that move 6 plus run another 3. And yeah, we'll have another one here, so 6 basically, plus another 3 for their agility stat. So that's it, the rest of the placement token will enter Overwatch, so they won't be moving this turn. So that's it for now, I'm jumping onto my movement phase. Movement phase here, I have this guy here that is going on top here. To climb here, he needs to do an agility test. So let's try that. He can only fail on a 6. And on a 3, he didn't fail. So he is on top here. Just remind that there is a building over here, so he don't see anything else on that side. There is a roof at the same height here. The rest of the team here will just do a tactical move just to go behind the window here. So I basically have that guy that is crouching, looking beneath that. We have one guy here, and we have just my leader behind the shoulder of them. Here I have Sasha. Sasha will do a new agility test, a 1. She successfully go on top of the dumpster and enter the building to join the rest of the team. So that's it for now. So now what I'm going to do, actually, Maya here just saw those two placement tokens move in front of her. So I'm going to unveil actually those two placement tokens. So the first one that moved in front of her was a civilian. The second one was also a civilian. Two civilian will be placed here. One thing though is that we have that sniper here that were looking at the alarm of the car. And he was actually looking towards my direction. That guy here, he advanced carefully and he moved, but the sniper might have spotted him. He can spot him on a 6. So let's roll that. Ooh, we were lucky. I saw that 6 coming. So he didn't see my guy for now. So right now we are safe. And we can jump onto, actually, I didn't move Maya, so I'm going to move Maya here. Because I want to move her inside the compound and start to do some detection. So here Maya have line of sight on displacement token. I'm going to unveil that. We have a new civilian on here. So yeah, there was a lot of civilian on that mission. When I rolled the card, there was 9 potential civilian here. So there will be a lot of civilian, but it's an industrial area. People are working inside here. There is just the Russian forces that try to maybe secure that because they have some shipping, some boat, some army boat, some shipping boat that bring some equipment later. Maybe something like that, but still have a lot of American people that work in there. So that's the end of the movement. We can jump on to the next turn. So new turn, while the alarm on the Range Rover is still ringing, I'm not going to roll for any Fog of War card. Also, one thing is that I'm going to just play with 6 Fog of War cards, no matter what it is, even if it's 6 clear cards. I'm stopping after I draw the first 6 cards for every mission, just because that could be endless and there could be like reinforcement and new things arriving, just to keep the video a bit short. I will try, last one was 2 hours anyway, but yeah, just to reduce a bit the time and crazy things that happen. So on that new turn, I have this drone. I'm just too close to the wall here, so the drone just playing with a U-turn and doing the same thing, moving on the edge of the board, advancing 30 inches. So next turn, this turn he will be able to try to detect some new stuff. In addition to that, I'm going to do a tactical move with this guy here. So he's doing a tactical movement. He have an agility of 5. That means he can move 5 inches. That will bring him roughly toward the edge of the roof here. He will be harder to detect. So he was already quite hard to detect. He was on a 6, but since he's crouching on top of that roof, let's say that the enemy in front can't detect him. My team here will stay put for now. The goal really is to detect that level 2 team and to assess the situation and to see how we can take that group down. I was hoping for that group to be toward the entrance. If it's like far away around here, I will need to go loud and enter that camp. So that's it. I've moved my team. I'm just going to move also Maya here. I want to detect the 2 placement token here. So Maya will move 6 inches towards this position here. She have line of sight on the 2, but it's pretty far away. So let's say that she detect. Oh, I've lost my die. So she detect those two guys on a 4+. So 1 and a 3, she didn't detect any of those. So that's it for my movement. We jump on to actually no enemy placement movement, enemy token movement, except this one. So this group is reaching the car. He's chatting that nothing is going on over here, false alarm. But still, the rest of the enemy remain in overwatch this turn. Ready to fire at any potential threat, and that's it for this turn. Actually, can I have that drone? Is on the edge of the board, but it's at the height of the highest point on the battlefield, so we have actually line of sight on those. He also is equipped with a thermal scope, so he detects them. He can only fail on a 6. And on a 4, he detects one of these placement tokens. Where is my deck? It's here. And the first one is clear, so nothing over here. So that's actually, let's try to do a detection test also with my sniper. What can he see? He can't really see well this one, but he can see the one below the crane. He can detect that one on a 4, 5, 6. And on a 1, he doesn't detect it. So let's jump onto the next turn. Next turn, we have a Fog of War card again on a 6. It's restart. So a 1, no Fog of War card this turn. Yeah, I'm going to try to go inside that camp. So here, Maya will move, but we'll try to stay a bit in cover just to get line of sight on that. She, is it? No, I don't think it's within 12 inches. So she detects on 4, 5, 6. And she detects what we have here. Please, the level 2. Ah, another civilian here. So this will be a civilian. The sniper will try to detect this again on a 4, 5, 6. And on a 5, he also detects what we have here. And what do we have here? And another civilian. A lot of civilian. So yeah, that's about it for detection. I'm tempted, you know what? I will maybe reevaluate my my move, because there is that 3-man team that is bothering me. The enemy will be in that camp, so I will need to go inside that camp. That enemy group, I'm not sure where he will move, but I can try to just move my team out and try to take him down. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to do that. So now it's my movement phase. Ah. No, I can't this turn. That sniper is in Overwatch. If I'm going out of that building, he will kill my guys. So yeah, first thing, this turn I'm going to try to kill that sniper, and we'll see what will happen next. So my movement has ended. I'm just going to move. Actually, no, there is still that drone here that need to move 30 inches. Oh, actually, that will allow me to unveil this token. It's automatic since I'm very close. And another civilian on that placement token. So let me grab one of the civilian here that I'm going to place on that placement token. So yeah, as I told you, lots of civilian in that shipping port area, they're working here. So yeah, that's the end of my movement. We jump onto the enemy movement. So first, this group here will actually not move. They are still checking what's happening with that car. And we have that enemy group here with the leader that is moving just 1 inch in front of the 7-Eleven. So I'm going to pause the camera, move the other placement token, and we can jump onto the combat phase. Okay, so one slight problem. Sniper here is equipped with that sniper rifle. You have silencer, but shots can still be heard one range interval of the weapon, so 32 inches in that case, and the group that is just below the building will hear. So what I'm going to do instead is fire with the guys that are inside the building. I'm going to fire with my crew inside. So my crew is inside that building, they are looking through the windows. I'm going to fire at that guy. So that guy, let's say, will receive a plus I will have a minus 2 modifier first, because it's in a high position and there is also the barricade in front of the windows. So yeah, minus 2 modifier for that. Let's check the range. So the range is 27, and both my guy equipped with carbines have a range of 16, so it will be outside of that first range, though they have a 4x scope that will give them a plus 1 in that second range interval. So I will start with Wolf here. He will do a rapid fire at minus 1, but plus 1 of the scope, so that's a total of minus 2. So a 6 and a 3. He's equipped with... No, he doesn't have any... Yeah, I can't reroll any die. He have no grip on his weapon. So a 6 and a 3. He have a shooting stat of 6. So here we have a 12. Minus 2 because of the range and the guy in a high position. That's a 10. And here we have 6. And that's a 7. So we have a 10 and a 7. The enemy can't beat the 10. Can he beat the 7? Yeah, he can beat the 7. Let's check that. A 3 plus defense of 2, that's a 5. The enemy didn't beat that. So basically here, the first shot touch the enemy, the second shot kills him. I don't even need to check lethality because again, the first bullet touches him, the second bullet kills him. So here, we spend 2 ammunition and we are at 3. So that guy here is killed. One sniper less to deal with. So now that's done. Yeah, that's basically it. That's the end of my combat phase. We can jump on to the next turn. Next turn, we have a Fog of War card on 5. Oh, and 6, a new Fog of War card. Oh, clear, perfect. All clear, Charlie Mike, continue mission. So, yeah, I will jump right away onto my movement phase. Here, that drone here will move 30 inches, roughly toward the end of the table. And so he's at the height, roughly this height. He will try to detect one of the guy on the pier. And let's say on a 4, 5, 6, he detect one. And on a 5, he detect one, so the one that is over here. Level civilian. Okay, so one more civilian there. I'm going to move my team and show you that just after. So here Maya is moving towards the rear of that industrial zone. She has a line of sight on one token and it's clear, so nothing on that token. Then where is that last enemy group, the one I'm looking for? Actually, it's not the last, they probably have more enemy, but yeah, that's... we'll see. Here on that side, I did a tactical move, so I'm advancing carefully, trying to not make any noise, to not be heard by that team, and indeed they didn't hear me. So yeah, my goal is to approach them and kill them, but now we jump onto the enemy movement phase. For that, I'm going to, as usual, roll my 2 dice and see where this unit is moving. Okay, perfect. So they move 2 inches in that direction, so they are moving away from me. So that's good. The next team here, which is on the back, will do the same. It will move. Actually, it won't move. It will just look in that direction. I'm not sure what this team is doing. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's the only enemy on the board. I'm going to pause the camera, move some of the placement token with my 2 dice, and we can see you for the next turn. New turn. We have again a new Fog of War card on a 6 and a 1. No new Fog of War this turn. Jumping onto my movement phase, I need to approach this team to take them down, and I will move Maya towards the back of the warehouse just to try to detect more of this placement token. So here, first thing, my drone is arriving on top of the con lines here. He will detect automatically this placement token that we have on the deck. What do we have here? And one enemy level 1 on there. So what do we have? Rolling my dice, and we have a 5. A 5 is one train rifleman, one train sniper. So this is the 2 guys. Sniper is looking in the direction here. That one is looking there for now. Maya, which is she's just behind that container, will detect that placement token. So I'm going to unveil one new card. That one is clear again. So nobody there. Next, I move my team over here. I was too short to be able to engage them safely, so I put them in cover behind that car. Also move that guy just so he can have a line of sight on them in case something goes wrong. That's the end of my movement. We jump onto the enemy movement. It starts with that patrol here, and it is moving 5 inches in that direction, so not in my direction, which is great. I'm lucky today. So they just maybe check the car, and now it's time to go back to the sidewalk and come back to the entrance of the camp. Now checking that second team here. Okay, so again, they are not moving, they are just turning, looking in the other direction. And luckily, all my guys are actually well hidden by that bus shelter here. So we are good. That's it for... actually, we have that new team that just arrived. So the sniper is on that container. He won't move, but this guy can move. And he's moving, 5 inches. He won't drop in the ocean, but he will just stay here on the edge. So that's it for this turn. We can jump on to the next turn. So new turn, we have a Fog of War card on 5. One, no Fog of War card. I'm going to move my drone on the board edge, like here. I'm going to move Maya, just so she can have a line of sight on that guy. I'm going to do a tactical move, just to give her that plus one in defense. Actually, by the way, since I'm here, I'm going to unveil right away that token. Oh, finally! Finally! Ah. I could have found that one earlier. So we have that level 2 enemy group. What do we have on that group? We have, it's a bit broken, but yeah, let's say it was 16. 16, we have, okay, we have 3 professional riflemen and 1 professional machine gun. So a 4-man squad of professional soldiers. Okay, I'm going to place down those. And next, I'm going to also move my team. Okay, so here we have that professional quad, that squad that just spawned. And here I've moved my guy ready to engage that enemy group. So that's the end of my movement phase. We jump onto the enemy movement phase. So this squad here will move. And he won't move in my direction. They are just checking that wall. So I'm fine with that. I'm checking that second team here. And they are moving 6 inches away from me, which is exactly what I needed. 6 inches in that direction. The only problem here is that I need to have line of sight on that enemy commander just to kill him before he raises the alarm in case something goes wrong on that side. Now let's check for him. He's moving 5 inches in that direction. And for that professional group, oh, he is moving 4 inches in the direction of Maya. Okay, that's not perfect. That's not perfect. So 4 inches in that direction, 4 inches in that direction should bring them here. Yeah, let's say on a 1-2-3, they will go on the left side, and 4-5-6, they will go on the right side. Please, 1-2-3. Yes, 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 yes. So here they are moving towards this direction. The thing is here, my agent is undercover, so she can be in line of sight, but if a Russian model enters a 6-inch area around that that model, he will try to arrest that character, that model. So it won't be detected, but they will try to arrest her. So right now we are safe and I need to move her away. That's it for now. We can jump onto the next phase, which is the combat phase. Okay, so combat phase. I have Sasha here that will fire at this guy, Wolf that will fire at that. Actually, Tex will fire at that guy, and Wolf will fire at that last one over here. And we have the leader, just in case one of them is not killed. So here I have Sasha. Sasha is doing an automatic fire, firing 3 bullets with her MP7. So 1-2-3, I'm going to remove those dice out of the way. So we have 3-3-1. She is equipped with a grip that allow me to re-roll one die when doing an automatic fire, and I did exactly the same roll. So 3-3-1, I'm well within that 8-inch radius, range interval. So I have a plus 3 in total, compact, red dot and laser. I have a minus 2 because of the automatic, so that's a total of plus 1. She have a shooting stat of 6. So basically here we have 7, 8, 9 plus 1. Here we have 2, 10. The enemy have no way to beat that. Here is his card, he have a defense of 2. Even if I roll a 6, that will be a 8. That's not enough to beat any of those 10. So that first enemy is killed right away. We jump onto the second combat. Second combat, I said it's Tex. Tex is doing a rapid fire, so 2 shots. Yeah. 2 shots in rapid fire. Oh, a 6 and a 5, there is no way the enemy can beat that. He have plus 2 because of compact and laser, minus 1 because of the rapid fire, so that's still a plus 1 in total. Indeed, no way to beat that. The enemy is killed. And then we have Tex over here. Tex is doing also rapid fire. I need to reload on the next turn. So, the enemy can't beat the 6 here. What do we have? He have compact plus laser side, that's a total of plus 2, minus 1 because of the rapid fire, that's a total of plus 1. So here we have a 4, plus a shooting stat of 6, that's a total of 10. The enemy have no way to beat that. So here I just killed the 3 of them. Fully suppressed weapon, subsonic ammunition, as you can see here. Subsonic ammo, so the shot can't be heard. So we are good. End of the combat phase. We can jump onto the next turn. Nothing else to do around here. Next turn, we have a Fog of War card on a 4. A 2. No Fog of War card this turn. So the plan, now that I know where the team is, I will get Maya out of that small compound and I will try to have Maya closer to the enemy commander. Maybe she will try to kill him. I will also try to place my sniper in a position where he might be able to see the enemy commander, we'll see. And in the meantime, my team here will move here, will jump on top of that wall and will get inside that compound. So that's my plan. So let's jump onto the movement phase. End of my movement, my team here just moved towards the wall, they all run so they can't fire this turn. I have Meilan here moving on the roof to try to get line of sight on the sniper. And I have Maya here behind the small truck that moves 6 inches too. So that's it for now, we jump onto the enemy movement. The guys on the boat moving 3 inches, so actually, yeah, let's just say that there is a ramp or something, and here he moved 3 inches in that direction. Maybe he wanted to check or just to hear what those civilian has to say. Now we have that group over here, that group is moving 2 inches back towards the pier, moving 2 inches back. Like that. Now we have the enemy commander team, which is here, and is moving 2 inches. They keep move towards my insertion point. So maybe they receive some intel about a potential enemy threat, or maybe some civilian is working with them and they heard that they saw some American soldier over here, who knows. So that's it for this turn, we can jump onto the next turn. Next turn, Fog of War card on a 3. Ooh, a 3, Fog of War. Clear, yes! All clear, Charlie Mike, continue mission. So that's it, now we jump onto the movement phase. My 4 guy here will do an agility test to climb on top of that wall. So let's check. Text have an agility of 6, he can't lose. Wolf here can fail his agility test on a 6. He doesn't. Sasha can also, she has a 5 agility, she can fail also on a 6. Oh, she failed again her agility test. She's not very good at that. And we have the leader that can also fail on a 6. Okay, we have 2 fail, come on. Okay, so we have Wolf and actually Tex and Wolf that jump on top of that. The 2 others will remain in base contact with that wall. They will just turn around in case something comes from that side. The rest of the team here will start to move. Yeah, just like that. Yeah, something like that. Looks cool. So the team has moved. Maya here on the other side. Let's do that together. She will move 6 inches. She will try to get out of the compound pretty soon. And yeah, that's about it for my movement. We can jump onto the enemy movement. Enemy movement. No, it's not my scattered dice. So the one on the pier here is moving 3 inches towards there. The our target group is moving 2 inches toward their original starting point. And the leader team on the back here. So they just move, yeah, 6 inches following the board edge. Something like that. So that's it for now. We jump onto the next turn. New turn, we start again with a Fog of War card on 6. A 2, no Fog of War card this turn. So, jumping on to my movement phase right away, I'm going to do an agility test. I can fail only on a 6 for both of them. So for the leader, he successfully jumped on top. For Sasha, and she also successfully jumped on top. So she climb, move on top. And he actually, what he will do, he will just move on top and move over here. Yep, bring the car so he can slip in here. And same for Sasha, she will just follow him. So that's it for these two. Now for the rest of the team here, they will move 6 inches. They will arrive roughly over here. And you know what? They are not in line of sight on any enemy, so they will do the, yeah, they will actually run another 5 inches right there. Same for my second guy here. So some civilians are a bit afraid, they just maybe move in some random direction, same like that one. They saw some soldiers, so they don't want to be caught in the crossfire. So that's it for this guy here. So now we have Maya here. She will move 6 inches in that direction, plus another 5. She will actually run, so she will arrive just in front of the truck on that side. For my sniper, I'm not sure what I want to do. I don't want to move here just to not raise any attention of the enemy squad around. So yeah, I'm just going to do a tactical move, moving here but not peeking. Yeah, just want to be close but not visible. So that's it for my movement. Jumping to the enemy movement, the enemy squad here, our target, they don't move but they face the entrance of the camp. For this little guy alone, he's moving 6 inches towards the warehouse. And for the team here, do they still move toward my insertion point? And yeah, they just move actually 6 inches again in that direction. So when I have that is touching the board head, what I'm playing, how I'm playing that is that it just reaches the board head and it follows the board head in the most logical direction. So if it's in this direction, it's on the right, and if it was something like that, it was in the left. So here, team is advancing there. So that's it for the enemy movement, right? Yeah, no more enemy movement. I'm not using the drone anymore. It's not anymore on station, just because I don't want to discover all the rest of the potential enemies. Actually, no, you know what? I'm going to do, yeah, the drone will move in that direction again. Not available, not useful this turn, but I want to try to detect what's over here. because that might be some more enemies to deal with. So that's it for now, we can jump onto the next turn. Next turn we have a Fog of War card on a 5 and a 4, no Fog of War card this turn. We jump onto the movement, so you know what, the first thing I'm going to move here is Maya. Maya is moving 6 inches plus another 5 will bring her roughly over here. So that's it, Sniper is staying in position, or you know what, he will do tactical move, he will move here just to get line of sight on the enemy on the other side, and yeah, let's leave that enemy squad like that for now. Now for the rest of my team, I'm going to pause the camera, move the rest of my team and show you that just after. So I move my drone just to get like 30 inches, so we have line of sight on the enemy token. I'm going to roll the die on a 4-5-6, I can detect what we have here. And a 5, we can detect one of the last, and that's a civilian, so one more civilian on the boat, we are safe for now. Here the team started to advance toward the enemy squad they need to kill. So yeah, the two here did a standard move, the two on the back just reach out and did a combat sprint. But yeah, that's about it for this turn, we jump onto the enemy movement. We start with our enemy squad here, they don't move, they just look roughly in that direction. And the guy in front of the warehouse, just sticking in front of the warehouse, trying maybe to open the door to see what there is inside. Now on that side here, the enemy is not moving, looking on normally that direction, but yeah, just for more logical reason, they will stay in that direction here. So that's it for this turn, we can jump onto the next turn. Next turn, Fog of War card on 4. Oh, I think I've lost my die just below the deck, damn it. So, a 3, so no Fog of War card this turn, we jump right away onto the movement. I'm going to pause the camera and move my team in the best position to try to set up that ambush. Okay, so we have two guys that went on the left, we have two guys, well, the leader and Sasha went on the right here. On that side we have Maya here that is getting closer, Sniper didn't move, ready to fire on the enemy squad, or maybe the Sniper on the back, we'll see. And yeah, that's it for the movement, no action this turn, no combat phase this turn, we jump onto the enemy movement. Starting with that enemy squad is moving actually 4 inches, not in the direction I want. Let me grab my ruler. Actually, it's just here. Okay, so they are moving 4 inches in that direction, so they move 4 inches behind that container, so out of sight of my second team if I move them, so yeah, that's not perfect. Yeah, that's it for this team, the guy in front of the warehouse, yeah, he just quit trying to open that and he's linking with the other team. Then we have that small team right there. That's really, yeah, maybe they just do a U-turn. Move 5 inches in the opposite direction again. So that's it. Yeah, that's it. Jumping on to next turn. Next turn, Fog of War card on a 3. And a 6, 1 Fog of War card. Unknown movement. Remove 1 card from the enemy force deck and randomly remove 1 placement token from the board. Actually, that's the last placement token and I actually counted and I know based on the mission, I know there was one last enemy group, and actually, yeah, there is just one last card. So we get rid of the last enemy group, which is great. So that was good Fog of War card. So that's it. Now jumping onto the movement, posing the camera so I can think at what I want to do. The first thing I'm doing here is that Maya will throw her jammer. The jammer is a device that blocks all electronic within a 10-inch radius. That means that once deployed, the enemy won't be able to call in reinforcement. It can be deployed like placed on the ground, or it can be thrown like a grenade. So here, what I want to do, Maya is just on the corner of the building. She will just throw that object roughly 5.5 inches, so it's still within our first range interval. I want to throw that device here. So that will place the enemy commander in range, canceling the call for reinforcement action. So let's check if the grenade, the jammer land exactly where I want. Maya have a shooting stat of 5. I need at least a 3. And a 5, the jammer land exactly where I want. The enemy is not alerted by that, it's just a jamming device, but if he try to, yeah, just take his radio and call in some reinforcements, yeah, he won't be able to. So that's for my first action. For the rest of my team, I've moved the two guys here on the left, I moved those two guys here also on the left. My strategy right now, nothing will happen this turn, hopefully, really depend on the movement of the action of the enemy squad. But what will happen here? I have my sniper that is aiming at the enemy sniper here. The thing is, I can't cross over those containers because yeah, that sniper will see me, will try to engage me. So my sniper on top, he's targeting that guy. So hopefully next turn, sniper kill that sniper, then the team will assault the enemy position here. I have some cool ability on some of my models, so we'll see what we can do with that. But yeah, that's the end of my movement. We jump onto the enemy movement first. Starting with that squad here, so the big squad. He's moving 6 inches towards the brick building, so he's moving not exactly where I wanted. So they are moving, they arrive just behind that SUV here, so they arrive right here. So they have a 90 degree view angle, so they didn't saw my team yet. Now for the guy alone here, the guy alone is turning again toward that warehouse, not sure what he thinks is happening in there. Maybe a training facility for some special force, yeah, who knows. Now for this team here, so they are moving actually 6 inches, let me grab my ruler again. They are moving 6 inches in that direction, so perfect, still in range of the jammer, actually even more, yeah, closer to the jammer. Okay, so that's great. Yeah, that's the end of that turn. We can jump onto the next turn. So, new turn. Just for your information, usually I'm filming those videos across multiple days, so that's why maybe sometimes the lighting is changing, or also maybe sometimes I forget a couple of things that happened in the last turn. But yeah, back on new turn, we have a Fog of War on a 6. A 4, so no Fog of War card this turn. Something I checked is that Sasha here have an ability that allow her to move actually 9 inches per turn, and I completely forgot that. So I'm going to jump onto the movement phase, letting you know what I want to do. Those guys here, they will actually enter Overwatch. Yeah, both guys will enter Overwatch, so we'll see, based on the movement of this unit, what will happen. Sasha here will come back here and join that group. The leader here is staying here just to take care of that Russian guy, and the sniper, the plan for him is to take care of the sniper over here. I also moved Maya here just because I have something in mind and I'm going to show you in a couple of turns probably. So end of my movement, we jump onto the enemy movement, and this might get spicy if this turn towards my ghost. So let's actually roll the dice and see where they are going. Okay, so no, they are not going in my direction. So basically, they are moving another 4 inches in that direction. Oh, damn it! They actually move them out of sight from my team. So checking with the ruler, they will move... So the first one here will move 4 inches. So the first one will arrive here. Actually, the rest of the squad will just follow on behind. You know what? That's actually enough. I will try to lob in some grenade exactly in the middle of the group here, and that should do some damage. But we'll see that in the combat phase. So let me grab again my scatter dice, and now I will move that guy over here. That guy is moving 2 inches, so perfect, not towards me. And we have the enemy group here. So as you can see here, we have 3 turns until the jammer battery is depleted. Okay, so that's all for the enemy movement. We jump onto the combat phase. So combat phase, the first thing I'm going to do here is with my sniper, I'm going to fire at the enemy sniper in the back. So here, Meylan loaded an armor piercing magazine just to negate the body armor of the sniper. I'm going to do a single fire. I can only do that anyway. I have a scope that gives me +1 in the all but the first range interval. That means here I have a +1 because of the scope. I have also a +1 because I am in prone or supported position. I didn't move this turn. And I also have a +1 because I'm in an elevated position. So that's a total of +3. So let me roll my die. A 6 plus 3, that's a 9. I'm adding my shooting stat of 6. This 15. Yeah, trying to count same time English and French was a bit too hard, but yeah, 15 total. Even with double 6, the enemy can't win that, and he can't roll double 6. He can just roll 1, but yeah, 1 in defense. Plus 2 points in defense of that guy. Actually, he's not alerted, so that's a 1 point in defense. So that's the lowest he can roll. A 2 in defense against a 13. The enemy is definitely hit by that bullet. So now let's check the lethality. It's a 3 plus lethality because indeed we negate that body armor. And a 5, that's a kill shot. So here we have that guy that is killed by my sniper. So now the next thing here, I have my leader here that he will target the Russian guy over here. So my leader, William Dunn here, will do a standard fire with the FAL. So checking the stat, he have one red dot and one laser sight, so +2. +2, yep, that's it, +2. Oh! 2 plus 1, that's a 3. Shooting stat of 6, that's a total of 9. The enemy, actually, the enemy can't even beat that, right? 6, 7, 8 plus 1, that's a 9. If the enemy rolls 6 plus, basically, when an enemy is not alerted, the defense is reduced to 1. So 6 plus 1, that's a 7. Even if it was a 2, that was an 8, that's not enough to beat my 9. So that enemy is hit by that bullet. So now we check lethality, it's a 3 plus lethality. And a 5, that's a kill shot. Actually, it's a 3 plus, but because the enemy is wearing a body armor, that's a 4 plus. And a 5, it's perfect. The enemy is killed. So here, that guy is killed. So now we throw in some frag grenade. So I'm going to throw that. Do I throw that with the closest guy? So let me check the range. So 6 inches, where does that land? Yeah, I will be in the second range interval anyway. Even if I throw it with my first guy, I'm already in the second range interval. So what I'm going to do instead, so 12, yeah, actually I will throw it with Sasha here. Sasha is aiming directly, let's say, at the wheel, at the left back wheel of the gray car. So let me mark where I'm aiming with that grenade. So I'm placing my grenade exactly, you know what, yeah, it just on the tire here. So basically, if I land exactly here, that will be a kill shot on that guy because he will be the only one in that 1-inch kill radius. So let's have a look at Sasha. Sasha have shooting stat of 6, minus 1 because of the range. Let's do that. Oh, I fail, I miserably fail. So 6 plus 6 minus 1, that's a 5, plus 1, that's a 6, and I needed to score an 8. That means that grenade scatter. So let's say, let's check where this grenade actually scatter. Let me just bring, take my red die. So here, the grenade will scatter. Oh, where does it scatter? Okay, so 3-inch in that direction. Oh, that bring that grenade towards me, actually. So 3-inch. Let me pause the camera and place where the grenade land. So Sasha grenade land exactly over here. And basically, only one guy is in the blast radius, which is the guy on the back here. So let's actually do that. I'm going to just mark that Sasha used one of her frag grenade. So frag grenade, it's a 4 plus lethality, but because the enemy is wearing body armor, it's a 5 plus. It's a 1, so definitely not a kill shot. So now we check the wound. And it's a 2, damn it, that's a... where is my table for the wound? As you can see here, it's a medium wound. The model is stunned for 2 turns and suffer minus 2 to their move and agility stat for the remainder of the game. So not too bad for the enemy, but bad for me. So that was it for Sasha. Now I still have two guys that will throw in some frag grenade. So I will start with Tex in the back. He will throw exactly at the same spot. Exactly at the same spot. So it's here. Tex have a shooting stat of 6. Damn it, the same roll, the same roll. I again fail to land my grenade where I wanted. Okay, so they are really, this team is really not good at throwing frag. So let's check where that grenade land. So it land, okay, so it land 5 inches in that direction. So it land roughly over here. So nothing happened on this turn, nobody is injured. I'm trying to think if with the last guy I want to throw a grenade or if I want to actually fire or something. No, I need to fire that grenade, I need to throw that. You know what? Wolf have an ability, fire your side weapon at a target. This action can be done at any moment and the unit can still move and make usual combat phase. So you know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to use his ability. I'm going to do a rapid fire on one of the guys at the... you know what? If I do that grenade and I do it well, I might need that ability later. So let's do that grenade. Same thing with Wolf, throwing my grenade exactly in the same spot. So please, not a one. You know what? I'm going to change dice. Where is my yellow dice? So yes, please, please. What? What? You saw that like 3 times in a row, rolling on a 1 on 3 frag grenades. Oh, I'm so unlucky. Oh, that's going to be a bad day for the home schools, maybe. So, checking where that grenade scatter. And it scatter again 5 inches. So instead of here, actually, that might touch the first one, let's check. So the third frag grenade lands exactly over here and actually nobody is injured by it again. So that's really, really a shame. So that's, that's pretty much it. I fire with that guy. I throw 3 frag grenades, nothing, nothing did well. The sniper killed the guy. Yeah, that's it for this turn. We can jump onto the next turn. So, next turn, we start with a Fog of War card on 5. And a 6, we have a Fog of War card. Okay, what do we have? Oh, some new enemies. One Russian soldier with an LMG and its assistant enter the area from a random building or vehicle. Roll randomly to determine point of entry. Okay, so that's not perfect. Two new guys that enter the board. So, first thing, roll to determine. So, 1, 2, 3, it will be a building. 4, 5, 6, it will... Well, actually, a vehicle won't make really a lot of sense. Actually, maybe one here. Trying to think, because I walked through here, so if there was some Russian in those two vehicles, yeah, they would have been alerted. And in the civilian car, that doesn't really make sense. So let's say on a 1, 2, 3, it will be a building, and on a 4, 5, 6, it will be that van over here. And a 2, it's a building. So how I'm going to divide that? I was actually in those buildings, so yeah, they won't be going out of here. The most logical thing is for them to be in the industrial zone here. So let's say on 1, 2, 3, they will be getting out of this building, of the main gate here. And on 4, 5, 6, it will be this building. And a 6, they are going out of this building, right in front of my leader. Funny how things, when they are randomized, can sometimes do logical action. So here, just kill that guy here, grenade explode, and we have some Russian soldier that appear. So they are here, we can jump onto the initiative phase. Now the alert is raised, I'm going to roll for initiative. Let me compare the stat from my commander. He have a stat of 5, and the enemy commander have a stat of 4. So let's see who wins the initiative. I'm going to roll. Oh, 2 for me. And if the enemy do 3, 4, they won the initiative. Okay, so the Russian will start first. Okay. Really not good. Really not good. Okay, so let me pause the camera. A bit. Actually, before I need to check if this group here is entering Overwatch. They have some enemy in line of sight, so they might enter Overwatch. All the others don't have any enemy in line of sight, so they are not going to enter Overwatch. So on a 5 or 6, they are entering Overwatch. 4, they are not. Okay. So now I can think of what I want to do. So I will place my sniper here in Overwatch. And I will place also Sasha here in Overwatch. The two guys here plus my leader, I'm not going to place them in Overwatch. I need really to move them. Same thing for Maya here in the alley. She's not entering Overwatch. So now we jump onto the enemy movement. So bringing this table closer to me to see the action of the enemy. So first for the big group, the big my target group. I'm going to roll 2 dice to see what their action will be. So a 2 and a 5. A 2 and a 5. It's flank and rapid fire. Flank and rapid fire. So they will try to flank my team which is here. So they're probably going to move on this side. Yeah, because just my team was looking in that direction. So yeah, they will move on this side. Now for the second team over here. A 3 and a 1, a 3 and a 1, move to closest cover and grenade. Oh, that's dangerous, okay. Okay, and the other group here, they just heard some grenades happening, exploding over here. They will just move, and if no line of sight, they will rush toward, that where they heard the grenade. So let's actually move our enemies. So, let's actually trigger some Overwatch. So, I started for first. This team actually move in their position. Not doing anything with that team for now. Here, I'm going to trigger some Overwatch. So first, the last guy here that will start to move to his new position. As soon as this guy is starting to move, it was the guy that was the most on the back, it will trigger the Overwatch from Sasha. So let's have a look here. So first, those guys are Russian airborne. So I will take the professional card. So Sasha is doing a standard fire at minus one because the target is moving. So 6 plus 3, that's a 9, minus one, that's an 8. She have some accessory, but it's outside of that first range interval. That means I also receive another minus one. So 6, 8, 7, that's a total of 7. Now we check the defense. Yes, we check the defense. Oh, 1, I'm lucky. They have a defense of 1. So I actually touch that guy. Lethality normally on a 5 plus, but these guys are equipped with body armor, so it switched to a 6. A 4, it's not a lethal shot. Now we check the wound. Oh, 6! Perfect, it's a catastrophic wound. The model is injured and is he will die in 3 turns. So I can consider him as he's actually unconscious, so he can't do anything else that game. So this guy is almost dead. So that's great. Now I'm going to trigger the sniper here. Sniper will target the second guy here, this one. So same thing here, I'm just going to remove one ammo from Sasha and I'm going to remove one ammo from my sniper. So firing in Overwatch, oh not great, 2, minus 1 because of Overwatch, that's a 1. Shooting stat of 6, that's a total of 7, but I didn't move, so plus 1. I have a high ground, so plus 2. 6, 7, so that's a total of 9. Rolling the defense, it's a 2. The enemy didn't beat my attack roll. So how lethality, it's a 3 plus lethality, should be a 4 plus, but I still have 2 ammunition from my armor piercing round, so I ignoring the armor. And it's a 5, it's a lethal wound. Okay, so this guy here with the LMG, he is killed. So that's great. Now, nothing else happening here, nothing, no more Overwatch triggering. I was actually very lucky with those Overwatch shots today. So that's it for the Overwatch. I'm going to keep moving the enemy, so this team will move 6 inches. And since they won't have anybody in line of sight, they will move another 4 inches based on their agility stat. So right now the enemy commander is still barely in range of the jammer. So next turn he won't be able to call in reinforcement, but the turn after he might be able to. So that's it for the enemy movement. We can jump onto my movement. So actually, not a good position. First thing, my leader was here. I could have moved in the container area, but those guys were planning to throw at me a grenade. And if the grenade land here, trying to kill me wherever I went, this will probably kill that civilian, and killing one civilian is fine, killing two civilians is a mission lost. So I decided to move my leader over here. He's in cover behind those barrels, but it's just really to avoid them throwing a grenade at me. And now we have the same exact problem over here. There are a civilian exactly in the middle, so maybe he's just afraid here. The firefight is hiding behind that. The thing is, if that enemy is firing and miss me, it will hit that civilian. So I decided to move text here in the open, so it will be just a more interesting target for that enemy, and that enemy will target Tex. Here on the back I have Wolf that move here to try to kill the guy that is already injured there. So that's that's not perfect. So let's jump onto now the combat phase. So combat phase, those two guys here are too far to throw a grenade at me, so they will just fire with their direct fire weapon. One of them is equipped with an LMG, the other one with an AK-74. Okay, so that's their weapon, even though the name is not correct here, it's not an M240, my bad. So the first one here, he will fire with the LMG, will do an automatic fire, so 3 shots. A 6, a 5, and a 2. They are firing in, this guy is firing in automatic, that means it's a minus 2 to the shooting. Another minus 2 because I am in a good cover, that's a total of minus 4. Minus 4, but plus 4 because of my shooting. Minus 4, plus 4, that cancel basically each other. So here we have a 6, a 5, and a 2. In total. So here I have a 3 and the 2 it's automatically done. So now I need to beat a 6. I have 3 points in defense, so I need a 3 plus. A 4, I beat that, and here I need 2 plus. Oh, and a 1. Oh, damn it. How? Oh. So that bullet actually touched me. I have 1 injury. Now let's check the second guy. The second guy on a 1-2-3 is doing a rapid fire. And on a 4-5-6, 1-2-3 standard fire, 4-5-6 rapid fire. So he's doing a rapid fire at minus 1. Okay, 1 and 2, he completely failed his 2 shot. But there is still 1 bullet that touched me. So let's take my medical table. Here it's a 4 plus lethality rifle, so it's the table in the middle. Going to roll that, and it's a 12. Okay, so 12, it's a lower torso with a bleed out. Actually, yeah, it should be a 12, but because I'm wearing a body armor, it switched to an 11. Lower torso, I'm starting to bleed out, and I receive 4 points of damage, which is really not great. Also, when my body armor is hit, it can't be used anymore. So basically, yeah, I'm very vulnerable right now. And yeah, we'll need to put the injury marker, and I'm bleeding out, so that's not really good. I need to, damn it, I have 1 injury to take care of now. So as you can see here, my leader is injured and is bleeding out, and here I have also marked that on his soldier board. So now we can jump onto the second combat. The second combat, it's basically this guy here. This guy here that will target a text there. So let's check just the weapon from this Russian model. And it's an AK with laser, and it's a 4x scope. So yeah, we will get a plus 1 in shooting in that first range interval because of the laser sight. So let's take the card out. So I thought I'd add another card, but actually it's this one, it's the AK-105. He can do a rapid fire, and actually they were supposed to do a rapid fire. So 2 dice, a 3 and a 2. 2 dice at minus 1, so here we have a 2 and a 1. So 2 and a 1. Plus 1 for each of them because he's equipped with a laser sight. Actually I can stay on that 3 and that 2. This guy have a shooting stat of 5, so here we have a 5, so here we have an 8, and here we have a 7, so rolling defense on the 8. A 1, ooh. I have 3 points of defense, plus 1, that's a total of 4, so here I fail, that shot touched me. The second one is, like I said, it's a 7, right? Yes, 7. Oh, I failed the 2 roll, damn it. So here, text receive 2
shots. So let's actually head over here. So what does he receive? So two shots, again, same table, 4 plus lethality table. Oh no, 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 no! The first wound is a 19, is a headshot. He's not equipped with a helmet, so there is no way to diminish, to remove a point from that wound. So here, that Russian guy here has just killed my techs here. Oh, damn it. Okay, so that's done. So one casualty, one injury, not really good. So that's it for now, right? No more Russian can fire at me. I jump onto my combat phase. During my combat phase, there is not much I can do. So the first thing here, I will take my wolf here. He will do a double tap on the guy on the back here. So he's here, he will do a double tap. So rapid fire. Rapid fire 3 and 3. He's not equipped with a grip, so he can't reroll any of those. He have compact and laser sight that give that a plus 2. So here we have basically 2-5 plus a shooting stat of 6. So it's actually plus 2 but minus 1 because of the rapid fire. So yeah, that's basically 2-4. Plus shooting stat of 6, so here we have 2-10. The enemy, even on a 6, he can't beat that, right? They have 2 points in defense. He plus 6, that's a total of 8. The enemy can't beat that. So 2 shots. The first one touched him, the second one killed him. And actually, he was already injured. That was the guy that was in the blast of the frag. So actually, yeah, the first shot killed him right away. So I can remove the stun marker. So now, done here. Is stunned by the shot that he receives, but he will still try to hit one of the Russians. Russian will get another plus 2 in defense because they are behind those barrels. So let's see, he's doing a standard fire, a 5. I am stunned where he is. I am stunned with him. So instead of the 6 point of shooting, it's only a 1. So here we have a total of 6. The enemy is in a pretty good cover, so plus 2 points of defense for the cover. Oh yeah, no way. So that's 6 plus, yeah. He completely failed his targeting roll. Just going to remove one ammo from his magazine. So yeah, that's about it. I just forgot one thing in my movement phase that I'm going to do right now. Is just to move Maya 6 inches in that direction because I have a plan, but I will tell you in another turn. So that's about it for this turn. We can jump onto the next turn. New turn, we start with a Fog of War card on a 6. A 5, no Fog of War card this turn. So we jump right away onto the command phase. Command phase, I'm going to roll one die for the ghost. Oh, damn it. So 5 plus 1, that's a total of 6. Now rolling command for the Russian. So that's again the Russian that has the initiative, the Russian going to start first. So now, do some of them enter Overwatch? So this team enter Overwatch on a 5+. They don't. This guy here enter Overwatch on a 5+. They don't either. And the team here doesn't have line of sight on anyone, so they don't try to enter Overwatch. So that's basically it. Now I jump to my phase. Do I enter Overwatch with someone? The sniper. The sniper, I'm going to place him in Overwatch. And yeah, so he will be in Overwatch, and that's pretty much it. So we jump onto the enemy force movement phase. Enemy force movement phase, I'm going to start with this group here. Double four, we have hold and fire. So they are not moving this turn, they are holding in their position. So it makes sense, they are in a pretty good position, 2 points of defense for each of them. So they are holding and they are firing. Now for the other guy here, let's try to see what he will do, a 5 and a 3. a 5 and a 3, Reckless Move and Rapid Fire. Reckless Move and Rapid Fire. So maximize movement, no try to be in cover. So what he would like to do? So he, this guy, he saw one model moving here, and he also have her in line of sight. So it was just check the range. If he's in range to that guy to enter melee, he's not. Let's say that on the 1-2-3, he will just move and face this guy, and on the 4-5-6, he will move in the open here to try to, maybe just move in the open. It's a reckless move, so no try to use cover. He will just move in the open. So 1-2-3 here, 4-5-6 there. So 1-2-3, he will come back on the back here, and he will face Wolf. You know what? I'm going to trigger Overwatch from the sniper. Yeah, let's trigger Overwatch from my sniper. So, sniper is firing one bullet at minus one. A 4, minus one, that's a 3, but plus one because of high ground, plus one because I'm static, I didn't move, so that's a total of plus one. So it's a 4, plus shooting stat of 6. Yeah, that's a 10. The enemy can't beat that even with a 6. So now we check right away the lethality. Lethality of the weapon is 3+, and it's a 3. So I kill that guy with my sniper. So this guy here is killed. So that's it for this unit movement. This is one is not moving. Now this one is moving 6 inches toward the gunshot. And you know what? They actually heard that sniper. They heard that sniper. So right now they are still one big team. In the following turn, they might try to break down to send a group trying to to climb on top of the building, but for now, you know what, they will move, just try to take position here from the sniper, so they will move in cover here, I will have one there, the commander will stay in cover, and they will, they don't have any line of sight on the sniper, maybe they just see the top of the barrel. But yeah, they don't have line of sight, but they just move in a logical position based on the fire from the sniper. So that's it for the enemy movement. We jump onto my movement. So here, my leader, William Dunn, is bleeding out. He has been moving from 5 to 4 at the start of this turn, and the injury went from 4 to 5, so now he has a minus 2 on holy stat. We need to take care of that injury really soon. But first, let's move him out of the way. So I'm going to move him 6 inches right here behind, in between those containers. And during that movement and tactical action phase, I'm going to use my tourniquet here to stop bleed out. So here I can remove that. He's still injured and I still don't have any medic. So he won't be able to be healed this turn and he will keep that minus 2 on all stat. But at least he's not losing any more blood. So that's it for him. Now in the middle here. You know what? I have a wolf on the back. Yeah, I don't want to risk some more losses. So I'm going to move the team as much as possible. So 6 inches will bring Wolf roughly over here. But I just want to rush toward the extract. I killed the team. That my objective has been completed. So for now, mission is a success. So I will just move 6 inches and basically run. I'm going to run with that guy. Sasha will do the same. She will move 6 inches. That will bring her here. And she will just run towards here. So yeah, I just want now to get out of the board, and that will be my extract probably. So that's the end of my movement. The enemy don't have me in line of sight. They can't shoot. We jump onto the next turn. Next turn, Fog of War card on a 5. A 1, no Fog of War card. Who has the initiative? So for me, a 3 for the Russian. 5, the enemy again has the initiative, damn it. So, nobody try to enter Overwatch because they don't have me in line of sight. What they will do, yeah, no Overwatch on their side. What they will do here is just do a breakdown. So those two guys here will remain there. The rest of the team here will move toward the rear to try to intercept my sniper. That's it. That's it. We jump onto the movement phase. So the Russians start first. Let's move them. So here we have a first team. There is one guy looking that direction. The other one is looking at the roof. Here we have that team that started to advance. My eye staying here for now. The jammer is only lasting again this turn. So next turn, enemy will be able to try to call in reinforcement. Here, those guys, they see my leader move on the left, so they just decided to move on that side to try to block him. And yeah, that's it for the enemy movement. We jump onto my movement. End of my movement, my leader just move over here. Wolf is covering the back. We have Sasha here that is also covering the back, but is pretty far with her SMG. My sniper move on that side here, just to still have some Russian in line of sight. And here I have Maya that is behind that that car. So that's it for my movement. We jump onto the combat phase. I have those two Russians that have two of my ghosts in line of sight. So, oh, actually, damn, bad move, because here the Russian will target Sasha, but if he miss, that will hit probably that civilian. So let's have a look. What does this Russian try to achieve? Is it 1-2-3 standard fire, 4-5-6? It's a rapid fire. Oh, damn it! Two chains to touch that that civilian, or me, and he missed the two shots. Well, not sure he missed, but he have a shooting stat of 4. Here it's a rapid fire, so minus 1. So 4, 5, 6, 5, that's a 5, that's a 4. Actually, I'm also behind cover, behind the back of that SUV, so I gain another minus 2 to defense, so that's a 4, 5, 6. So basically, that's a 3, that's a 2. I have a defense of 3, so he missed all his shot. But then that civilian was in the middle of the gunfight and is hit by one of those shots. And yeah, let's check the wound. The first one is just a slight wound. The second one, well, the first one is a light wound, but the second one is a kill shot. So first civilian killed, not good. But that's it, and now we jump onto that guy. That guy with the LMG will fire at Wolf. So, 3 shot is firing in automatic since he moved this turn. Okay, so automatic, it's a minus 2. Another minus 2 because I am in cover behind that truck. So that's a total of minus 4. So here we have... So here we just have a 5. And Wolf is here. He have a shooting stat. He have a defense of 4. Actually, even if I roll a 1, that's enough to beat that 5. So he just missed me. The two other shot was completely a miss. So he missed Wolf. So he evade all those shots. So that's it for Wolf. That's it for the two Russian here. Now, does that Russian there have line of sight? Actually, he may have misplaced my leader because that Russian here may see my leader. But let's say he suffer a minus 3 because he can really barely see him. He's equipped with an AK. He will fire one shot. No way to touch me with that 2. He missed his shot. So that's it for the Russian combat phase. I jump into my combat phase. So Wolf here will try to fire. Where is Wolf? He will do a double tap at one of the Russian. He's firing twice. 6 and a 3. Oh, I have some luck maybe with the 6. So I am firing in rapid fire, so minus 1. The enemy is in a pretty good cover, so an additional minus 2, so that's a total of minus 3. So here basically I have a 3, and here I have nothing. So here I have a shooting stat of 6, plus the 3, that's a total of 9, and that's just a 6. The rolling defense on the 9, there is no need, because he have a defense of 2, with a 6, that's a total of 8, that's automatically a touch. The second one, it's a 6. On a 4 plus, he beat that, so that he beat that indeed. So now we check lethality. It should be a 4 plus lethality, but Russian have body armor, so it's a 5 plus. It's a 2, it's not a kill shot. Now we check the wound. And it's a 6, catastrophic wound. The model is unconscious and begins to bleed out and will die in 3 turns. Okay, now Sasha. Let me check the range for Sasha here. So the enemy here is at 19 inches. So it's in the third range interval of that MP7, so she won't be able to do anything actually. Yeah, you know what, I will still do something, I will still fire. One shot. Oh, you know what? No, I'm going to fire in automatic. Yeah, I'm going to fire in automatic because I have a grip. I can reroll one die. So yeah, maybe with some luck. Okay, so 5, 3. We keep those. I'm rerolling the 2. So 5, 4, and 3. So it's a minus 2 because I'm firing in automatic. Another minus 2 because of the range, and another minus 2 because the enemy is in really good cover. So that's a total of minus 6. I have a shooting stat of 6, so I will just cancel that. So here basically we have a 5, a 4, and a 3. The enemy have a defense of 2. On that 5, I missed that shot. Now on the 4, he need a 2 plus. And a 2, missed that shot. And here he need a 1 plus, so it doesn't. No bullet touch him. So he missed all the 3 shots with Sasha. So that's done. Yeah, no more. Ah, actually, I have my sniper. I should have. I will fire with my. Can he see him actually? No, he can't. He can't because of that box truck. Oh, damn it. I should have checked that earlier. I should have fired with the sniper on the first one and Wolf on that second guy. That's the game. So that's it for now. End of the combat phase. We jump onto the next turn. Next turn, we have a Fog of War card on a 4. And a 4, a new Fog of War. Unknown movement, remove one card from the enemy force deck, and there is no more enemy force deck available. Like, I've spawned all the enemies, so nothing is happening with that card. So now we jump onto command. Command phase, I will roll for me. Oh, I have some luck maybe today, and for the Russian, yes, I win the initiative, so I'm going first this turn. Command action. I'm not placing anyone in Overwatch. Yeah, I want to move everyone. So no Overwatch this turn. The enemy on a 5-6, this guy will be in Overwatch. Oh, and a 5, he goes into Overwatch. So when I will try to move Wolf, he will attempt to fire at me. The others, they don't have line of sight, so no Overwatch on the other Russian. We jump onto my movement phase. Actually, before doing my movement, the jammer battery has been depleted, so the enemy will try to do a command test. The enemy commander is that 4 here, he can only fail on a 5 or 6. Oh, 5, yes! So he failed that call for reinforcement, so for now, no reinforcement enter the board. So now let's jump onto the movement. Okay, so here my commander, he moved 2 inches. He will try to deploy a smoke grenade over here. So he have a shooting stat of 6, but minus 2 because he's injured. That's a total of 4. Plus 2, he miss his shots. That means that the grenade is scattering. So now let's check where that grenade is scattering. 4 inches in that direction.
Okay, so 4 inches in that direction, that will land the grenade here. So here we start to have the smoke that appear. Okay, so not perfect, but yeah, that will do. That has to do. So here I just move the rest of my movement, so a total of 6 inches. Sasha is over here for now. I move my sniper on that side. What he's doing is setting up a rope. He's setting up a climbing kit because he will just move down that building with his climbing kit. So that's it. Now Wolf is starting to move. When he starts to move, that will trigger the overwatch from the Russian guy. So he's firing at -1. Because of Overwatch, -2 because Wolf is in a really good cover, so here we basically have a 2. Shooting stat of 4, that's a total of 6, checking defense on Wolf. Oh! 6! Wolf have a defense of 4, plus 1, that's a 5. That Overwatch shot actually hit Wolf. Damn it! So let's check the injury now. We take that table here. It's an AK, so the 4 plus lethality table, please, not a kill shot. A 9, 9 is not kill shot. 9, it's a lower torso wound, 2 points of damage, no bleed out. Because I have a body armor, it should be lower than that, but actually that's the lowest injury I can get, so it's still that lower torso wound. Okay. So I was really afraid for a moment, but it's not too bad. So Wolf will still do his 6 inches movement after being hit. So we'll just move, roughly here. And yeah, he could try to run, but because he's stunned this turn because of the shot, he can only do an extra 1 inch movement. So, oh yeah, actually, let's do that. There is no more enemy. We'll just do that 1 extra inch movement. So that's it for now, that's it for my movement. We jump onto the enemy movement. So this guy here fired in Overwatch, so no movement for him. We jump onto the Russian, the other Russian. Okay, so that team is over here. There is just one guy checking this side, the other guy looking down here. They will probably try to move or maybe enter Overwatch. We'll see what happens next turn, but that's it for now. So again, yeah, this is depleted, no more jammer. The rest of the team here, what could they do? They hear some gunshot happening over here, they see the smoke. Maybe they will just try to look in that direction. Yeah, that would be the most logical action. So let's say that they are looking in that direction. And yeah, that's it for now. That will be hard to jump on top of that building. But I know that there are enemies here and I have some more smoke, so we'll see. That smoke actually here is lasting, I think it's D3 turns. 3, so that's 2 turns. 2 turns that smoke is lasting. So that's it for now. We jump onto the next turn. I reach the max amount of Fog of War card. It's a maximum of 6 per turn, per game. So I draw 6 of them. So no more Fog of War for this game. So we jump onto the command phase. Command phase, who will have the initiative? First for me, a 2, not great. Then for the enemy. It's a 4, so the enemy has the initiative. Eesh, not great. Do I want to play someone in Overwatch? No, nobody in Overwatch. For the enemy, for this team here, do they want to enter Overwatch on a 5-6? They don't. For this guy here, this guy is entering Overwatch. And for this team, do they want to enter Overwatch as well? Yup. And a 4, they don't enter Overwatch. So that's it. For me, no Overwatch either. I'm jumping onto the enemy movement. So this guy here, the most logical thing for him will be, yeah, maybe, you know what, to move towards the gunfight, but stay in cover. That will provide him plus 2 in cover. So this team here, on a 1-2-3, yeah, they will just basically move behind that car. So yeah. This guy moving up here, this guy moving Yeah, you know what, they are both looking that direction, or maybe this one is looking there. Or maybe this guy is still checking the roof. Yeah, something like that. This team here is moving another 6 inches towards the rear. So 6 inches. Same for this guy, same for the commander. So that's it for the Russian. I jump onto my movement. So this guy here is just going down with his climbing kit. So he's just moving down with the rope. Can he be seen on the side? No, he can't be seen by the two guys here. So he's just basically roughly towards the bottom. Now we jump onto the movement over here. Wolf actually is just moving here, do a tactical move, granting him an additional point of defense. On this side, grenade will last one more turn. On this side, I will have Hopi, my leader here, that will throw a smoke grenade just on top of the wall. So something around that. Let's see if he successfully do his roll. Be a 6. A 5, I might have some chance. So he's here. He have a shooting stat of 6, but minus 2 because of his injury. That's 4 plus 5. Yeah, that's enough to do that 8. I did a 9 and I needed an 8. That means that the new smoke grenade land exactly here. So the grenade here will actually last 3 turns, a 5, that means 3 turns, that's really perfect. In the meantime, I have Sasha here. Sasha will do an agility test, hope she will be better at the start of the game. She can only fail on a 6. Okay, so she don't climb the wall. My leader here, William Dunn, you know what? I need an agility test to climb on top of the wall, but you know what, I'm going to just move here and move here. To do that, I don't need an agility test. I need it in that side because the wall was really high, but here I can just move on top of here, move on top of here, and just jump on the other side. So that's it for her, and I'm going to do the same thing with him. So he's moving and he will roughly arrive just there. So that's it for those two guys. I hope that this guy will manage to do the agility test to jump on top of him. We'll see. So that's it for now. That's it for now. And Maya, what does Maya want to do? You know what? Maya is moving 6 inches towards them. We'll see what she will do, but yeah. We might have some close combat over here. We'll see. So that's it, we jump onto the combat phase. Combat phase, the Russian here will fire at Wolf first. So the Russian will do 1, 2, 3 standard fire, 4, 5, 6 rapid fire, so a standard fire. A 2 plus shooting stat of 4, basically the 2 cancel each other with the defense provided by the pallets. So it's basically a 4 in shooting, and I have a defense of 4 on Wolf, so the Russian miss me. No more fire from the Russian, we jump right away on my combat. So my combat, I will have Wolf. He have only one bullet left in his weapon, so he's doing a standard fire. A 3 plus, I am within 16, am I within 16? Where is my ruler? Here. So 16 is right there. No, it's my second range interval, so I am not within 16. I will get a plus 1 because I have a 4x scope on that rifle, so I still get a plus 1. So it's a 3 plus 1, that's a 4, plus shooting stat of 6, that's a total of 10. Minus 1 also because of the range, that's a total of 9. Even on a actually, that's a 9, minus 2 because the enemy is in a good cover. That's a 7. The enemy can beat that. 5, 6, 7. Yeah, they actually beat that. They have 2 points in defense plus the 5. That's enough. I missed the shot with Wolf here. So that's it for the combat. No more combat for me. We jump right away on next turn. So next turn, I'm doing that initiative roll again for me. for the Russian. Six again once. Okay, so the Russian again start first. Do this guy here, this one here, enter Overwatch on a 5 or 6? He doesn't. Does this guy enter Overwatch? But I don't really have anyone in line of sight. We'll see. Let's roll. 5 or 6. Okay, so they enter Overwatch. So this guy looking in that direction. There is the smoke, so he won't be able to do anything. You know what, that doesn't really seem logical. Yeah, they don't enter Overwatch. But this one here, for not entering Overwatch either. So that's it. We jump onto, yeah, for me, no Overwatch, I want to move. We jump onto the movement. So that Russian, what I think would be the most logical would be to move something like that. This one, yeah, doing something like that. This one here, you can see Wolf, but he see that there is not a lot of cover. And what, he will move 6 inches to reach the rest of his friend. On this side, where is my ruler? So this team here is doing a 6-inch movement and they arrive exactly there in front of my guy. Damn it. Okay, so that's it. We jump onto my movement. My movement, I have Sasha here. Okay, wait one. Last turn, I forget to do that call for reinforcement again. And a 5, the enemy failed that call for reinforcement again. Now I'm doing it for this turn. He failed again on a 5-6. And a 1, he successfully do that call for reinforcement. So now reinforcement arrive in D6 turn. There you have in 4 turn. 4 turn, in 4 turn, a new reinforcement will arrive and we still don't know what it is yet until it arrives. So now Sasha here is moving 6 inches, she arrives here and you know what, she will go overt. She is switching, she's throwing her bag here and she is taking out her silence pistol. On this side here I have a Meilan that is finishing his move and you know what, he will... Yeah, will... No, I need... They will fire first, so I need to enter hand-to-hand combat with this guy. Yeah, I need to enter hand-to-hand combat. That will be tough. That will be tough. Okay, so that's it. For now, this on this side, this guy is moving here, doing an agility test. A 4. What is his agility? He have an agility of 5, so he can only fail on a 6. That means he successfully jump on top and arrive here. And yeah, that pretty much it. The rest of the team here will move. Checking the range. 6, she will arrive behind the BMW. Same for this guy. And actually, you know what? Can this guy see? Okay, so this guy can barely see Sasha. So he will try to fire at Sasha, but the rest of the team here will just move outside the board from that board edge. So that's it. We jump onto the combat phase, probably the final combat phase. So combat phase, first thing is to resolve that melee fight. So I'm going to roll for the ghost, I'm going to roll for the Russian. Okay, but I started the combat, so I have a +1. I also have a knife, so that's a +2. So here I have a 6, here I have a 5. I have a melee combat stat of 6, the enemy have a melee combat stat of 4, so I actually win that hand-to-hand combat. So here I kill that guy with my knife. But there are still those two guys. Yeah, there are still those two guys. And I can't do anything else for now. So that's it for this. Now it's the enemy combat, so here this guy will fire at my guy. He's doing a rapid fire with his AK-74U. A 3 plus a 2. is having a minus one because of the rapid fire rule, but as you can see here, he's equipped with on top of his gun he have a red dot, so it's a plus one. So here the plus one and the minus one cancel each other. He have a shooting stat of 5. So that's an 8, that's a 7. Rolling defense on the 8. I fell, so this bullet touched me. Rolling defense on the 7, please. Oh, 5. Where is my sniper? 6, 7, 8. I avoid that shot. So there is still one bullet that touched me. 4 plus lethality weapon again. What do we have? An 8. Arms, I'm injured on the arms, 4 points of damage, and I'm bleeding out. Not perfect, but at least I am not killed right away. That officer here is just equipped with, let's say, a basic Makarov, even though we don't saw it, so he'll still try to fire at me. 1, 2, 3 standard fire, 4, 5, 6, so 1, 2, 3 standard fire. A 5 plus shooting stat, commander, shooting stat of 4, that's a total of 9. Ooh. Oh, 6, 7, 8, 9, I successfully avoid the shot from the commander. So maybe the commander was trying to fire when I was still in hand-to-hand combat and he missed his shot. So now, the last shot is from this guy here. He can really barely see Sasha. So he's equipped with, let me take out the card. He's equipped with that PKP, but yeah, just the way he's handling his weapon, I'm not playing with the encumbering rule, so he can move and fire. So he actually moves, so he can't do a sustained fire, he will do an automatic fire at minus 2, plus 1 because he have a red dot, and also minus 2 because I am in good cover, so it's a total of minus 3. Oh, and yeah, no way he can win. Yeah, so basically here the 3 is basically actually it's a 5. I need to roll. Where is Sasha? Sasha is here. I have 3 points on defense. If I roll a 1, that bullet touched me, and a 6, perfect. And the 2 other was automatically a miss. So here, yeah, that weapon is pretty heavy to carry, so struggling to fire, to move and fire at the same time, so he's just firing and all the bullets went into that BMW. So that's the end of the combat phase for the enemy. Now it's my turn. You know what, Sasha will try to throw in a frag grenade here. She will try to do that. Where is my ruler? Here. Can she actually do that? Yeah, she will try to land. She aim exactly at that enemy. Rolling the dice. And a 6 that land exactly where she wants. And that enemy is called within that 1-inch kill radius. So this guy is killed. So now I have Maya here on the back. Maya just took out her P226. She will do a rapid fire against the officer. Oh my god, 2 and a 1. She has a shooting stat of 5, but minus 1 because of the rapid fire. So here we have a 6, here we have a 5. Rolling defense on the 6. I actually touch him. Rolling defense on the 5. And I actually kill him. So I kill that officer. And that's it for this turn. No more. Yeah, no more fight happening this turn. We jump onto the next turn. Next turn, we still have that smoke. That means basically they won't be able to get line of sight on me, and I'm just going to move this team out of the table. On that side, there will be just hand-to-hand combat with those two guys here. So what will happen here? Please win. Please, Meylan, win that melee hand-to-hand combat. For me, oh yes. 5, no bonuses for anyone, so 5, but I have that close combat, I have my knife still in my hand, so 5 plus 1, that's a 6, plus melee of 6, that's a 12, for the enemy, yeah, 2, he loses his melee roll, and this is killed. And that rings the end of that mission. Yeah, it will take me a couple of turns to link up Maya. Well, at least one turn to link Maya with Meylan, and both will get out using that car, and they will just pick up the rest of the team with that vehicle and move away from this area. And yeah, mission done, successful mission, but we still have three injured guys. Wolf with a light injury, we have our leader with a pretty bad injury, and another one here, Meylan, that received also a pretty nasty wound. So it's not really not perfect. But yeah, that's about it for this mission. Now let's check our reward. So if you remember at the end of last mission, when we successfully complete a mission, I'm going to roll two dice. On a 1, 2, 3, I'm going to gain one new ghost, and on a 4, 5, 6, I'm going to gain one support card. This time, I'm going to cheat a bit. I want to unlock a bit more ghosts, and I want to have a bit more support. So what I'm going to do is throw four dice instead this turn. So don't blame me for that, but yeah, that's... So two new ghosts, two new support cards. Yeah, it's just that I have a lot of ghosts and I want to play with some of the cool ones I really like. So yeah, I hope I'm going to unlock some nice ones. So I've laid down all my ghosts. Let's randomly pick two of them. Let's start with maybe this one. Oh, that's a cool one. Clayton Pakowski with MK46 mod 0 is a silencer and a M72 low. That's great. A support guy with a silencer, it's really great. So now for the next one. Oh, nice! A recon class. I don't think I have one since the beginning, so that's going to be cool. The recon class is equipped with the recon drone. He's also equipped with that decoy, and it allows something pretty cool, so that's going to be really useful. So that's it for these ghosts. Now let's check the support card. So I have everything here. I'm going to pick two of them. I already shuffled the deck, and here, A10 cannon. Okay, so that might be useful if we have some tanks to deal with. And for the second card, let me pick one. And we have a jamming drone. Okay, so in case something goes wrong, I can call in that jamming drone that call in any potential call in for reinforcement. So that's cool. Okay, 8-10 cannon, jamming drone, plus two new ghosts. So sorry a bit for cheating and unlocking more things than what I should do, but yeah, it's just that I want to play with some of the cool rules, I want to play with the support, I want to play with more of my cool ghosts that I have in stock. So yeah, that's the end of that mission, hope you like it, I know it was again pretty long for sure, but yeah, see you for the next one, bye everyone!